chemistry channel. In this video, we'll talk about interconversion of mole concept. We will talk about what is number of mole, and also we will learn how to convert number of mole to number of particles, mass, and also volume at SDP and RTP. We'll look into what is actually SDP and RTP as well. Let's jump straight into what is actually mole. We always use the word mole in chemistry. What is actually that? Mole is a standard scientific unit in chemistry for measuring large quantity of a very small entities such as atoms, molecule, or ions. We know that atom, molecules, and ion are all very, very small particles in chemistry. So how can we measure the small particles? Atom is not something that you can use your spoon and scoop up one atom. No, it's too small to count like that. Therefore, we use the number of mole. Knowing that one mole is actually equals to 6.02 times 10 to the power of 23. We know that if I have 1 times 10 to the power of 3, that is actually equals to 1000. So what happened when you are actually having 10 to the power of 23? That much of zero at the back. So let's say if I have 1 mole of car. Alright, we can count the car. How many car we have? 1 car, 2 car, 3 cars. But if I say I have 1 mole of car, I means I have 6.02 times 10 to the power of 23 car. That is a lot of cars. Okay? So that is how much 1 mole. Why do we need such big amount? Because it's used to calculate the small entities, knowing that your atoms, molecule, and ions are very, very, very tiny particles. So we need to use a large value to calculate the small particles. That is actually mole. 1 mole is actually work exactly the same like 1 pair, 1 dozen, or 1 kg. We know that 1 pair is actually equals to 2 items. Okay? If I say I have 1 pair of shoes, that means I have 2 shoes. If I say I have 1 pair of glass, means I have 2 glasses. So 1 pair is always equals to 2 things. 1 dozen is equals to 12. 1 dozen of egg, I have 12 eggs, right? 1 dozen of apple, I have 12 apples. So 1 dozen is always equals to 12. 1 kg is always equals to 1000 gram. All this work exactly the same like 1 mole. If I say I have 1 mole, then it will be equals to 6.02 times 10 to the power of 23. That is 1 mole. So if I say I have 1 mole of egg, it means I will have 6.02 times 10 to the power of 23 eggs. If I say I have 1 dozen of egg, then I means I have 12 eggs. So it works exactly the same like others. If you can work out 1 pair is equals to 2, 1 dozen is equals to 12, why you cannot accept 1 mole is 6.02 times 10 to the power of 23? Just happen to be, in 1 mole, the number is a lot bigger. That's it. Okay? So let's look at how can we convert the number of mole into number of particle, mass, and volume. First thing, when I have number of mole convert to number of particles, the number of particles that we always talk about is atoms, molecules, ions. That is the number of particles that we will always use. I hope you remember the video that we talk about how to differentiate atom, molecule, and ion. You need to know how to differentiate atom, molecule, and ion. And to convert moles to number of particles, we will be using Avogadro constant, which is 6.02 times 10 to the power of 23. Next, we will change number of mole to mass, where in mass, we will always get it in the form of gram. And we will use molar mass in the conversion. Next, we look at volume at STP. So we will learn what is STP later on. And to change number of mole to volume, we will be using molar volume of 22.4 liter. Last but not least, we can change number of mole to volume but at RTP. And I separate the volume at STP and RTP because we'll be using molar volume of different value. For RTP, the molar volume is 24.0 liter. So make sure you can differentiate RTP and SDP. And for your information, both volume over here is only applicable to gas, alright? You can only convert the number of mole of gases into volume at SDP and volume at RTP. Alright? Simple. First and foremost, let's look into when your number of mole change to number of particle. Just a kind reminder, the number of particles that we can look at is your atoms, your molecule, and also your ions. Okay? So make sure you can differentiate which one is your atoms, which one is your molecule and ions. And the interconversion between the number of mole and particles will involve Avogadro constant. And a kind reminder, 1 mole of anything will actually equals to 6.02 times 10 to the power of 23. So if you say you have 1 mole of glass, then you will have 6.02 times 10 to the power of 23 glasses. Okay? If you have 1 mole of car, then you will have 6.02 times 10 to the power of 23 cars. So 1 mole of anything will be actually equals to 6.02 times 10 to the power of 23. Therefore, when I say I have 1 mole of sodium, alright, it means I will have 6.02 times 10 to the power of 23 sodium atom. Why is sodium atom? Because sodium is in the form of atom. And if I say I have 1 mole of oxygen gas, it means we will have 6.02 times 10 to the power of 23 oxygen molecule. We know that your O2 is in the form of molecule. Okay? And if I say I have 1 mole of Cl minus, it means how much? 1 mole is always equals to 6.02 times 10 to the power of 23 Cl minus ion. Alright, easy? So what makes it different right now is what particles are you having? Are you having atoms, molecule or ions? So it depends on is the number of mole of what particles you are talking about. But it doesn't matter what particles they are, as long as you are saying 1 mole is always equals to 6.02 times 10 to the power of 23. Alright, simple? That is the first conversion. Let's look at the second conversion. When we are going to convert your number of moles to volume and RTP. So let's look at what is actually RTP. RTP stands for room temperature and pressure. And room temperature and pressure represent room temperature is 25 degrees Celsius or 298 Kelvin. That is the room temperature that we mean. Pressure is 1 atm. Okay? So this RTP, your room temperature and pressure, is actually a condition. It means I can have oxygen gas at 25 degrees Celsius, 1 atm. That means it's room temperature pressure. You can have your carbon dioxide gas at 25 degrees Celsius, 1 atm. So 25 degrees Celsius and 1 atm represent room temperature and pressure. So RTP is actually a condition where your gas is exists, okay? And the molar volume of any gas, alright, 1 mole of any gas at RTP will be 24 liter. It means 1 mole of my hydrogen gas at RTP will be actually equals to 24 liter. 1 mole of my oxygen gas at RTP is equals to 24 liter. 1 mole of my neon gas at RTP is also equals to 24 liter. So it doesn't really matter what type of gas you are having. As long as you have 1 mole of gas, any gas at room temperature and pressure, that 1 mole will be equals to 24.0 liter. Next, we will look at volume at SDP. Just now we have RTP that represent room temperature and pressure. So how about SDP? SDP represent standard temperature and pressure. So what is mean by standard temperature and pressure? Standard temperature and pressure means 0 degrees Celsius or 273 Kelvin and the pressure at 1 atm. So, the standard temperature and pressure means 0 degrees Celsius or 273 Kelvin at 1 atm. That is your SDP, okay? And to convert your number of mole to volume at SDP, we will be using a molar volume of 22.4 liter. In the other words, 1 mole of any gas at your SDP will be equals to 22.4 liter. It will work exactly the same like just now. It means 1 mole of hydrogen gas at SDP will equals to 22.4 liter. So what does this mean? It means 1 mole of hydrogen gas at 0 degrees Celsius and 1 atm, it will occupy as much as 22.4 liter of volume. Okay? And 1 mole of oxygen gas at SDP also will take up 22.4 liter. 1 mole of neon gas at SDP will also take up 22.4 liter. The same thing apply as your RTP. It actually means 1 mole of any gas at 0 degrees Celsius, 1 atm will occupy 22.4 liter. It doesn't matter what gas are you having, okay? What does matter is what is the temperature, what is the pressure. 1 mole of any gas at this temperature and pressure will take up 22.4 liter of volume. Make sense? Simple. Next and last but not least, we are going to look at how moles can be converted into mass in gram. We'll be using molar mass. And we know that mass of 1 mole of anything is actually the molar mass. It means if I have 1 mole of hydrogen, then it's actually equals to 1 gram because hydrogen is 1 gram. If I have 1 mole of hydrogen gas, H2, that means I have 2 gram. 1 mole of oxygen is actually equals to 16 gram. So the mass of 1 mole will be actually equals to the molar mass. In the other words, if I have 1 mole of sodium, then the mass will actually equals to the molar mass of sodium, which is 23 gram. 1 mole of oxygen gas, O2, oxygen is 16 times 2. So 1 mole of oxygen gas will be equals to 32 gram. 1 mole of sodium hydroxide, NaOH, knowing that your Na is 23, your oxygen is 16, your hydrogen is 1. So 1 mole of NaOH will be equals to 23 plus 16 plus 1, which is equals to 40 gram. Alright? Simple. Molar mass will change depends on what atom or molecule we are going to use. Alright? Easy. Let's do some quick exercise for all this conversion. If right now we are having 1 mole of neon gas, what would be the number of atom, gram, volume, liter at SDP, liter at RTP. Easy. 1 mole of neon gas will be equals to 6.02 times 10 to the power of 23 atom. The molar mass of neon is 20.2. So 1 mole of neon gas will be equals to 20.2 gram. 1 mole of neon gas at SDP, ladies and gentlemen, SDP will be equals to 22.4 liter. 1 mole of neon gas at RTP will be equals to 24 liter. Okay, simple. Next, I have 1 mole of oxygen gas. Oxygen gas over here is a O2, it's a molecule. So how many molecule that we have if I have 1 mole of oxygen gas? I will have 6.02 times 10 to the power of 23, your Avogadro constant. Next, question asking for atoms. Can you differentiate that? Molecule means O2. Atom means what? Atom means O. So we know that one O2 will have two oxygen, it means I will have two atoms, okay? So one oxygen gas will need two oxygen atoms. So how many oxygen atoms I have in one mole? Easy, 2 times 6.02 times 10 to the power of 23, okay? Because 102 will need two oxygen atoms. See that? That's why you times two, okay? And oxygen gas mass will be 16 plus 16. So the mass of oxygen gas will be 32 grams. The volume at STP will remain the same. STP means the molar volume is 22.4 liter. The RTP means 24.0 liter. Okay? Simple. And I think the only things that make you confused is your molecule and atoms. Alright? Make sure you know how to differentiate molecules and atoms. Molecule means you have O2. Atom means we are talking only about oxygen. That's why you need to times 2 over here. 102 need 2 oxygen atoms. Simple. Next, we'll be looking at all the particles. We have molecule, we have atoms, we have sodium atoms, we have ions, and we have only cation. So let's go through one by one. I have one mole of NaOH. We know that NaOH itself, the entire NaOH, is a molecule because you have Na, oxygen, and hydrogen. So one mole of NaOH equals to how many molecules? One mole of NaOH will be equals to 6.02 times 10 to the power of 23 molecules. But in one mole of NaOH, we have how many atoms? In this NaOH, we have three atoms. We have Na atom, we have O atom, oxygen atom, we have hydrogen atom. So one mole of Na will give rise to three moles of atom. So how many atoms we have? Times three. Because in one mole of NaOH, there is one Na, one oxygen, and one hydrogen. So you times three. Next, so the question asking for only sodium atom. How many sodium atom we have? We only have one sodium atom. That's why one mole of NaOH will only equals to 6.02 times 10 to the power of 23 sodium atom. Okay, there is only one sodium atom. Next, how many ions are we having? We know that in one mole of NaOH, when we break it in the form of ion, you will have Na plus and also OH minus. When the question only mentioned ions, it means cation plus anion. We are looking for both. So, one NaOH will have two ions, okay? One NaOH will give rise to two ions, which is Na plus and OH minus. So, 2 times 6.02 times 10 to the power of 23. Is it? Simple. And last but not least, we have cation. Cation means we will be only looking at the positive ion. And the positive ion that we have is only Na positive. So over here, that is your Na positive. One NaOH, there is only one cation. Therefore, one mole of NaOH will give rise to 6.02 times 10 to the power of 23 cation. Alright? Simple. That is how we play along with it. And if you remember, particles, we have three things: atom, molecule, and also ions. So make sure you look very carefully right now. What are you having at the beginning? You're having molecule at the beginning. Okay? Question asking for atom. So you need to break down to how many atoms you have. I have three atoms. So 3 times 6.02 times 10 to the power of 23. Next, question also asking for atom, but question only asking for sodium atom. So in the NaOH, how many sodium atoms you have? One. So equals back to your 6.02 times 10 to the power of 23. Ions mean cation and anion. So in the NaOH, how many ions you can have? Two. And a positive OH minus. That's why you times 2. Last but not least, question asking for cation. cation that you have in this question is only an A positive. That's why only one cation. So the number remains 6.02 times 10 to the power of 23. And that is why it's so important to be able to identify what is atom, molecule, and ions. Okay? I have a video talking about that. If you don't really understand here, maybe you should rewatch the video talking about atoms, molecule, and ions. Okay? And if you realize, all the exercise that we have tried just now is at one mole. One mole of oxygen gas, one mole of NaOH. But what to do when it's not one mole? Because that is going to happen in your exam. The question will never give you one mole of oxygen gas, one mole of NaOH, no. The question will always give you 0.13 mole, 0.25 mole, 0.037 mole, whatever the number is. But it's not going to be one mole. So what happened when it's not one mole? We'll be using mole ratio and compare, and we will solve the mathematics. So let's start off with your first example. The first example is to calculate the mass of 0.245 mole of oxygen gas. And how do we solve this? Simple. I hope you remember that your moles can be converted into four things. Number of particles, mass, volume at STP, volume at RTP. And every interconversion will be using a different thing. You need to know what are you looking for. If now the question is asking for mass, so from number of mole to mass, we know that the interconversion is molar mass. Molar mass of who? Molar mass of oxygen gas. First thing, calculate the molar mass of oxygen gas. So the molar mass of oxygen gas will be equals to 16 times 2, which is 32 gram per mole. Okay, that is the molar mass of O2. Next, what is mean by mole ratio? Simple. We will be comparing to one mole. Always compare to one mole. One mole of O2 gas will be equals to 32 gram. Okay, remember? Now, I don't have one mole. I only have 0.45 mole of oxygen gas. So, 0.245 mole of oxygen gas will be equals to how many gram? Unknown Y. Okay, just put unknown, whatever unknown that you want. Okay, so Y gram. And we are looking for the Y. And it's very simple to solve the mathematics. Cross them up and times, alright? So 1 times y, you will have y, equals to 0.245 times 32, okay? So can you see the maths right now? Simple, solve it. And y will be equals to 7.84 gram. So 1 mole of oxygen gas is 32 gram. 0.245 mole of oxygen gas will be equals to 7.84 gram. And the mole ratio that we mean over here is this. This is what we call mole ratio. And mole ratio is extremely important in this semester. You must be able to use your mole ratio very, very well because it will carry marks, and we are going to use this method in a lot of calculation. And the technique of this method is simple. Always compare with the theory. Always start with one mole equals to how much. And equals to how much will depends on what are we looking for. If the question asking for volume, we compare with volume. If the question asking for number of particle, we compare with Avogadro constant. And now the question asking for mass, so we compare with molar mass. Simple, easy. Let's try another example. Calculate the volume of 0.467 mole of chlorine gas at 25 degrees Celsius and 1 atm. So we know that chlorine gas is Cl2. And question asking for volume. Volume to number of mole means molar volume. And we know that molar volume having two conditions, SDP, RTP. So 25 degrees Celsius, 1 atm is your RTP. And the molar volume of RTP is 24.0 liter. Okay? So next, what are we going to do? Mole ratio. We know that one mole of chlorine gas at RTP is equals to 24.0 liter. We are comparing it to the molar volume because question asking for the volume. And right now, we don't have one mole. We only have 0.467. So 0.467 mole of Cl2 will actually equals to how many liter? Okay, Y liter. How many liter we are actually having? So same thing, we are going to cross it actually. So do the maths. 1 times Y, so equals to Y, equals to 0.467 times 24. And then your Y over here will equals to 11.208 liter. Make sure you put down the unit. So this is how the mole ratio is working. And mole ratio is actually very useful over here because it will change your traditional method of memorizing by heart, whether it's a times or divide. Right now, this method will help you to remove the confusion. You always confuse whether you need to times or divide previously. Alright? So by using the mole ratio concept, you won't need to memorize it's a times or divide. You simply compare it with the theory. One mole is equal to how much? Right now, I don't have one mole. So how much will it be? Alright, see that? So it's not needed to memorize anything. Easy. You only need to remember the four conversion. Change it to number of particles, we'll be using Avogadro constant. Change to mass, we'll be using molar mass. Volume at SDP will be 22.4 liter. Volume at RTP will be 24 liter. Simple. Another example over here. How many moles of helium gas is needed to fill a 5 liter balloon at STP? So the question is slightly different over here. Just now we give you the number of moles and you need to find something else. Right now, I want to look for the number of moles by giving you the volume. And again, volume having two conditions. Volume at STP or RTP. Obvious, STP. STP means the molar volume between the mole and volume will be 22.4 liter. Okay? So the mole ratio come in with the theory. Always start with the theory. One mole of helium gas will give rise to 22.4 liter. We are comparing mole to volume because we are looking for the volume. Okay, so the interconversion over there is depends on what you want and what you have. And it's a 22.4 liter because it's a STP. Simple. So what would be the number of mole of helium gas if I am having only 5 liter? We know that 1 mole is 22.4 liter. What happened if I only need 5 liter? How many mole is that? Simple. Still the cross. Okay, so 1 times 5, 1 times 5 is 5, equals to 22.4 times x. So we are looking for the x, alright? So to solve the mathematics, your x will then equals to 5 divided by 22.4, okay? So your x over here will equals to 0.2232 mole of helium gas. Okay, simple. And what we are trying to do with this mole ratio again is to avoid you to memorize whether it's a times or divide. We don't want you to memorize by heart whether it's a times or divide. By using the method of mole ratio, you can remove the confusion. Last example over here. Calculate the number of hydrogen atom. So number of hydrogen atom. In the other words, that is your number of particles. Okay, we are looking for the number of particles of hydrogen atom. In 0.15 mole of methane gas, but the number of mole is for methane gas. Can you see the difference over there? You are looking only for hydrogen, but you have mole of methane gas. Anyhow, between the number of particles and the number of mole is definitely your Avogadro constant, which is 6.02 times 10 to the power of 23. But to find the number of hydrogen atom, you will need number of mole of hydrogen atom. Okay? So So you need to change this number of mole of methane gas to number of mole of hydrogen atom. And it's very simple to do that. 1 mole of methane gas CH4 will give rise to how many hydrogen atoms? Simple. 1 CH4 holding 4 hydrogen, guys. So 1 mole of CH4 will give rise to 4 mole of hydrogen atoms. Okay? And right now, I don't have 1 mole. I only have 0.15 mole of methane gas. 0.15 mole of methane gas will equals to how many mole of hydrogen atom? Remember the mathematics? Cross your ratio. So let's say that is your Y. 1 times Y. Y equals to 0.15 times 4. Therefore, your Y equals to 0.6 mole of hydrogen atom. And right now, you already have the number of mole of hydrogen atom. How can we change the number of mole to number of hydrogen atom particles? So now, you already have the number of mole. How can we change the number of mole to number of particles? Simple. Avogadro constant. 1 mole of hydrogen atom will give rise to 6.02 times 10 to the power of 23 hydrogen atom. And right now, I don't have 1 mole. We only have 0.6 mole of hydrogen atom. 0.6 mole of hydrogen atom will equals to how many hydrogen atom? And the mole ratio come in again. Simple. Cross. Let's say I put this as a X, looking for the X. So 1 times X, you will have X equals to 0.6 times 6.02 times 10 to the power of 23. As a result, X will equals to 3.612 times 10 to the power of 23 hydrogen atom. Okay, simple. Slightly different from all the previous question is you have 2 times of your mole ratio. You need to do twice of your mole ratio because what is the question asking for and what the question is given is slightly different. Question only asking for hydrogen atom, but the question gives you the number of mole for methane gas. So you need to find the hydrogen atom in the methane gas by using the theory of mole ratio. The theory always started with 1 mole. 1 mole of methane gas will give rise to 4 mole of hydrogen atom, the 4 over here. And we only have 0.15 mole of methane gas that will give rise to 0.6 mole of hydrogen atom. After you have the number of mole of hydrogen atom, then only we can convert to number of particles of hydrogen atom. At this time, we compare it with the Avogadro constant. 1 mole of hydrogen atom will give rise to 6.02 times 10 to the power of 23 hydrogen atom. 0.6 mole of hydrogen atom will give rise to 3.612 times 10 to the power of 23 hydrogen atom. Simple, easy. This interconversion of mole concept is extremely important because it's the basic core in chemistry calculation. And the new technique that I apply over here is mole ratio. We are no longer forced you to memorize whether it's a times or divide. Alright, we will do it in the form of mole ratio so that you don't have the confusion in your exam. And I hope this video will be able to help you to understand more about mole conversion. If it does, hit the like button, share it with your friend, and remember to subscribe to my channel. I'll see you back in the next video. Thank you for watching and have a good day.